Greetings. This video refutes argument number 8 from the random flood list sent by the Mohammedan. Let's look at the claim. According to Bible, God can't be a man because man is liar, Numbers 23:19. Jesus is a man, Acts 2:22, the Bible says. So Jesus is a liar because he was a man, and that is why Jesus can't be a God. So, according to the Bible, all men are liars. Jesus was a man, therefore Jesus was a liar. Muhammad was a man, therefore, I'm getting ahead of myself. According to Bible, God can't be a man because man is liar. Numbers 23:19. God is not a man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should change his mind. Does he speak and then not act? Does he promise and not fulfill? God is not a man who lies or a son of man who changes his mind. God is not like people. He tells no lies. He is not like humans. He doesn't change his mind. When he says something, he does it. When he makes a promise, he keeps it. I find that fascinating. God doesn't change his mind. When he makes a promise, he keeps it. Think about some of the promises God has made. But with Isaac shall I make my eternal covenant. Exodus 6:4, and I have also established my covenant with them to give them the land of Canaan, the land of their pilgrimage wherein they were strangers. Genesis 17:8, and I will give unto thee and to thy seed after thee the land wherein thou art a stranger, all the land of Canaan, for an everlasting possession, and I will be their God. And God said, Sarah, thy wife shall bear thee a son indeed, and thou shalt call his name Isaac, and I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting covenant, and with his seed after him. Remember, God is not a man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should change his mind. Does he promise and not fulfill? If you call yourself Muslim, you have to answer a question. Why do you make an argument from the phrase, God cannot be a man because man is liar, when you don't really believe or care what the Torah, the Word of God, says? The context continues with God fulfilling his promises. And I have shown you several promises of God you do not believe. You see, O Muslim, Islam has caused you to despise God. You actually believe that God is a liar because of Islam's claims and tricks. You believe God's covenant with the Jews has ended, and that means you think God's promise is worthless. You believe God's gift of the land of Israel to the Jews is over, and that means you think God's promise is worthless. Islam has taught you to think God is a liar, just like a man. And sadly, Muslim, you believe that God is a liar. Consider the error of the logic of this argument. All men are liars. Jesus was a man. Therefore, Jesus was a liar. You've missed it on several levels. First, with this argument, you've cursed Jesus that you claim Islam respects as a prophet. You have flat out called Jesus a liar. Beyond that, you missed another critical application of this verse in Numbers. All men are liars. All prophets were men. Therefore, all prophets are liars. Again, with this argument, you've cursed all the prophets you claim Islam respects. By Islam's stupid argument, Islam calls all the prophets liars. And you've missed the most damning application of your bad argument. All men are liars. Muhammad was a man. Therefore, Muhammad was a liar. Now, don't you feel ashamed, O Muslim, now that your argument has proven Muhammad is a liar? Did Islam teach you that such arguments trick and scare Christians? But let us take a look again at the logic of the Mohammedan's accusation. So Jesus is a liar because he was a man, And that is why Jesus can't be a god. As stated, the logic of Islam is that Jesus cannot be God because Jesus is a liar. He does not say, Jesus is a man, therefore Jesus cannot be God. His logic path is very clearly, so Jesus is a liar because he was a man. All men are liars. Jesus was a man. Therefore Jesus was a liar. Therefore Jesus cannot be God. So Jesus is a liar because he was a man, and that is why Jesus can't be a God. If it wasn't tragically stupid, it might be comical. And if you want more information, O Muslim, about God is not a man, you can watch my videos on the topic. God is not a man, parts 1 and 2. And I have a question for you, O Muslim. Do you think Islam can be explained using definitions from Shintoism? How about explaining the Quran and Islam using definitions from Hindu sources? Would you think a Hindu, using Hindu terms, could accurately tell what the Quran claims? Well, arguments from Islam that use wrong definitions will always misunderstand the true Injil. This argument, number 8, fails miserably because the poor person from Islam has not bothered to ever learn Christian definitions. But look back at the original claim and you may notice something different than other claims. According to Bible, God can't be a man because man is liar. Jesus is a man, the Bible says. So Jesus is a liar because he was a man, and that is why Jesus can't be a God. Did you see it? This does not follow the A-B pattern. The Bible says, but the Quran says. According to Bible, God can't be a man because man is liar. And that stands on the unstated fact that God cannot lie. But where does the Quran say that Allah cannot lie? Nowhere. In fact, the Quran says that Allah is the best deceiver, and that means best liar. And if you try and raise the commandment, thou shalt not bear false witness, Islam will retort, those are laws for men, not Allah, meaning Allah may kill, lie, and commit every other sin that is forbidden. And as an aside, I have never found a surah in the Quran stating, be holy even as Allah is holy. That does not mean it is not in the Quran, simply I could not find it, and I refuse to twist phrases to concoct something similar. And to be clear, I do not doubt Muhammad tried hard to claim his Allah was holy. One of Allah's superlatives is the Holy One. But that's a load of camel dung when Allah is the best liar. And the Quran gives more than one example where Allah lies to Muslims. Allah lied to Prophet Jesus in Surah 355. Allah lied to the disciples, Muslims, in Surah 4:157. According to Bible, God can't be a man because man is liar. At the very least, this establishes some very simple and irrefutable logic. God cannot lie. Allah lies. Therefore, Allah cannot be God. And certainly the Muslims' retort would have to be, only the Bible says that God cannot lie. But that only serves to prove that Muhammad's message disagrees with the message of the prophets. To which Islam can only retort, the Torah and Bible are corrupted. So you can see how clever and never-ending Satan's web of Islamic lies is. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.